What's up, MMA fans and high rollers? I am currently being joined by not only the number 7 flyweight in the UFC, but also dedicated and proud high rollers ambassador. Jessica, thank you so much for joining me. I see you're actually in the HQ right now. What's going on over there?
Yes, we just finished up training. So, and I helped do some cleaning before the big event this weekend. I just wanted to do my part and, you know, be supportive here because they've been so supportive of my fight camp.
And so tell me how that relationship started, because you were in with Strong Style for a while there. You came to Las Vegas. So when did you really hear about high rollers?
I actually have known Lonnie for a long time, Big Lon, and he's just always been one of the homies. And, you know, I got introduced to Matt, and along the way I was like, man, I love marijuana and I love training. I was like, and then they put the facility. I was like, is there ever a possibility I could maybe use it and, you know, make part of this my home? And, you know, in exchange, I will give you guys all the social media love. And they were like, Jess, we love you. Of course, you're more than welcome to. And I'd already seen Morano had did it. So I kind of followed some of his lead and asked as well.
Hell yes. They have so many different names in there. I know Walt Harris is in there sometimes, obviously, like you said, Brandon Moreno. And I think everyone not only shares the sense of love for marijuana, but the community that High Rollers attracts, it's always the best vibes of people. But in your particular situation, I know you've had stomach troubles in the past. Is the marijuana kind of used for something like that, or is it more physical relief?
All of the above, but yes, with the stomach issues that I've had, it's definitely been a huge help. Like, even to this day, like if I feel like I'm having somewhat of a reaction anytime I smoke or hit a dab, it will instantly help my stomach ache, helps with the nausea, helps with the dizziness. So yeah, it is definitely something that, you know, it helps me. And I'm love that I can bring it together. I love that I can do something I love and be able to do it here and be able to train at the same time. It's just so perfect. I was doing some training out of my house when COVID was, you know, in its heaviest moment. So to be able to do it here and be able to utilize like this now is great. It's like being at home again.
That's amazing. And obviously we see all your support online, but one of the call outs that I wanted to make was on Submission Underground. You were wearing our High Rollers merchandise. So thank you so much for doing all that. Just, is there anything that really you want to give a shout out to this tournament that people might not even understand that they're missing out with this tournament?
They're creating a whole new lane. Like they're giving, like, nobody's done this before. These guys are the originals. Like they can do, you know, they can create their own new lane for this. And it needs to happen because a lot of people are, you know, marijuana users. They do smoke, they do train, and they repeat it. And there's a home for us now. There's a place for people who, you know, are medical and medicinal users, and they have this and they can feel good about themselves while they do it here and feel just comfortable and not insecure about it. So it's completely a different lane that needed to be filled, and I'm so proud they did.
And just looking ahead, your last fight was at UFC 257, and now you're not going to have to deal with all the traveling and everything that happened with Fight Island. You're not going to have to deal with that stuff. Are you expecting anything different when it comes to the atmosphere that's going to be happening at the trilogy of Dustin Poirier and Conor McGregor?
Absolutely. It's going to be the first, you know, UFC that's open here in Las Vegas. So that alone, it's a Conor card, you know, and, you know, High Rollers is kind of putting on their own little fun event too here, you know, which is bringing some of the energy and the heat. So it's like, it's almost like International Fight Week. There's going to be fighters everywhere. There's going to be interaction. There's going to be marijuana. There's going to be alcohol. And there's going to be some badass fights and some really awesome wrestling and grappling matches. So, I mean, no matter what, if it's fight night or if it's, you know, High Rollers, you know, what is it? Four, right?
High Rollers
six. What's the name
now
of the event? High Rollers six.
Yes. You know what I mean?
So, like, it's going to be a huge event. Like, there's going to be so much action. There's going to be so many competitors in town, and it's going to be really exciting.
Yeah, and then we have the first ever Muay Thai Open with Joe Schilling. He's going to be helping host that, and that's, you know, the viral video that went out yesterday. We just have so many big names that are coming in, but are you going to be able to make it to the, I guess, after party? Maybe we'll see how it goes.
Well, Thursday, I'm going to stop by, I think, for a little bit, as long as the UFC doesn't have a stink about me coming over and breaking COVID rules, if there are any. But I should be able to be here and say hi to everybody on Thursday. But yeah, of course, after the fight, I'm here. This is my hangout spot. So I will definitely be here after the fight. It's very close to my house. So it's like, why not better to be able to smoke somewhere, be around cool friends, and be able to finish watching the fights? Because I'll be done earlier in the night. So it'll be awesome to be able to come back and watch the pay-per-view with all my friends here at the facility.
Exactly. We can't wait to see you. I can't wait to meet you in person as well. And someone I just wanted to kind of let you give a shout out to is I see how close you are with your brother. Is he ever going to be coming to any of the High Rollers event, or has he been to some?
Yes, he competed in the last one. Unfortunately, we're working through moving, so he's just been helping me out with fight camp and everything. He will be here, but he will not be competing.